New Spring takes place at the end of the Aiel War, which is a war that saw the Aiel invade the Westlands after the King of Kyrian, Laemon Demodred, decided to cut down the Alvendezora tree in order to make a new throne for himself. The Aiel saw this as a great insult and betrayal because they were the ones that gave the Alvendezora tree to Kyrian. During the breaking of the world, the people of Kyrian gave the Aiel water, which the Aiel saw as a great kindness, especially after no one else showed any kindness towards them during this period of time. In order to say thank you, the Aiel gave Kyrian a sapling of the Alvendezora tree and allowed them free passage through the Aiel waste. After King Laemon decided to cut down the tree, four Aiel clans went to go kill him. Now we begin with Moiraine Domodred. Moiraine and Swan Sanche are servantee to the Amaranth Seed, Tamara Ospenia, and the Keeper of the Chronicles, Gitara Moroso. As Moiraine is servantee to Gitara, she starts trembling and has a foretelling. Gitara Moroso foretells that the dragon has been reborn in the slopes of Dragonmount, and then she dies. The Amaranth orders Moiraine and Swan not to tell anyone about the foretelling, and then she orders all of the accepted to go around the area and record the names and place of birth of every child that has been born recently, but she doesn't tell anyone why she's doing this. Moiraine and Swan go to a nearby camp and they look for the child that may be the dragon reborn. They also hear rumors that the Aiel are finally retreating. When they return to the White Tower, Moiraine is told that her uncle, the King of Kyrian, Laemon Demodred, and two of his brothers have been killed by the Aiel. The next day, Moiraine is told by the Amaranth to stay in the White Tower to recover from the news of her uncle's death. So Moiraine and Swan decide to go through the list of children that are most likely to be the dragon reborn, and they save it for themselves. Moiraine is then visited by many Aes Sedai from many Ajahs, and they ask her about her thoughts on who will become the next ruler of Kyrian. Moiraine knows that the White Tower will want to make her the next queen of Kyrian, so she decides that after she is made Aes Sedai, she will leave the White Tower because she doesn't want to be the Queen of Kyrian. After some time, Moiraine finally takes the test to become Aes Sedai. She goes into the oval ring Terangreal and she manages to pass the test. Moiraine chooses to become an Aes Sedai of the Blue Aja. When she returns to her room, she finds out that Swan also took and passed the test and that she also chose the Blue Aja. Eventually, it is announced that the Amaranth Seed, Tamara Ospenia, died in her sleep, and an Aes Sedai named Sierin Bayou becomes the new Amaranth. Swan and Moiraine know that before she died, Tamara Ospenia sent out Aes Sedai to search for the dragon reborn, so Moiraine decides to leave the White Tower and join the search so that she can stop the White Tower from making her the next queen of Kyrian, but at the same time help with the search for the dragon reborn. Moiraine has a list of children's names that are most likely to be the dragon reborn, and she decides to go to the borderlands first to begin her search. After several months, Moiraine is joined by Swan, and she tells Moiraine that all of the Aes Sedai searching for the dragon reborn have died. The fact that all of the Aes Sedai that knew about the dragon reborn have died is too big of a coincidence, so Swan and Moiraine come to the conclusion that the Black Aja is real and they killed the Amaranth and her searchers to stop them from finding the prophesied hero. Moiraine and Swan are now the only ones that know about the dragon reborn, and they agree to go their separate ways, but they will meet in the city of Chachin to continue the search for the dragon reborn. On the way there, Moiraine comes upon two Malkyrie men and she follows them. When one of the Malkyrie men goes to the woods alone, Moiraine sneaks up on him and the men throws her in a pond. Moiraine is angry about this, but she decides to travel with them and so they go to Chachin together. The Malkyrie men introduce themselves as Lan and Bukama. Lan Mandragoran has returned to the Borderlands after spending years fighting the Aiel in the Aiel War. There were rumors going around that he died fighting the Aiel, and because of it, his first lover, a Malkyrie woman named Idaine Arel, raised the Golden Crane, which is the Malkyrie flag, and she's gathering an army to go retake their lost nation of Malkyr. When Lan was an infant, Malkyr was overrun by Shadowspawn and taken by the Blight. His parents ordered the best Malkyrie swordsmen to save and raise him. After the death of his entire family and the destruction of his nation, Lan Mandragoran became the uncrowned king of Malkir, and now his old lover wants to use his name to go retake Malkir, but Lan knows that it is not possible, and now he's going to Chechen to stop her. On the road, Moiraine pulls many pranks on Lan as revenge for throwing her on a pond. After they reach Chechen, they go their separate ways. Lan goes to see Idaine, who is staying at the queen's palace, and Moiraine meets up with Swan, and they continue their search for the dragon reborn. Swan tells Moiraine that the woman and child they are looking for are staying at the queen's palace. Swan and Moiraine go to the palace, and they come across Mirian, who is also an Aes Sedai, but Moiraine doesn't trust her. Moiraine also learns that Lan is the uncrowned king of Malkir, and she decides to go ask him for help. Moiraine wants Lan to help her keep an eye on Mirian and report on all of her activities. Lan agrees to help her, but first he wants Moiraine to tell him the reason why the White Tower didn't send any help to Malkir when Malkir died. Moiraine tells Lan the truth. She tells him that the White Tower sent over 100 Aes Sedai to Malkir, but they were too late. The White Tower decided to hide this information in order to save their reputation. Lan accepts her answer and tells his friend Bukama to keep an eye on Mirian. Later, Lan is attacked with the One Power and he falls down some stairs but survives. He's then told that his friend Bukama was also attacked and is injured. When Lan goes to check on him, he finds Bukama dead. Lan goes to confront Moiraine and she immediately realizes that Mirian is Black Aja and she's responsible for the attacks. They go to confront Mirian and they find her with Issel and Dirik. Issel is the daughter of Idaine and Dirik, the prince of Kandor. Rhine, Lan's oldest friend, is also there and Mirian orders him to kill Lan and he obeys. Mirian then kills Dirik and Issel with the One Power and a fight between her and Moiraine commences. Moiraine is not as strong as Mirian and she struggles to defeat her, but she is finally able to kill her by stabbing her with a knife, and Lan also kills Rhine. Afterwards, Moiraine goes to speak to Swan, and Swan tells her that the kid they were searching for wasn't born on Dragonmount, so he can't be the Dragon Reborn. Moiraine then tells Swan what happened with Mirian. Moiraine says that Mirian wanted to kill Dirik the most, but they don't know why. They then remember a story about Dirik surviving a fall that should have killed him, and they realize that he was probably a channeler. Swan and Moiraine come to the conclusion that the Black Aja knows that Dragon was reborn, but they don't know when, so they're just going around killing every male channeler they can find. They come up with a new plan, and they decide that Swan will go back to the White Tower and use the Blue Aja's eyes and ears to locate the Dragon Reborn, and Moiraine will travel the world searching for the prophesied hero. Lastly, Moiraine goes to see Lan, and she asks him to become her warder. Lan is not interested at first, but after Moiraine tells him that the dragon has been reborn and that they must find him, Lan accepts, and so Lan and Moiraine go off to look for the kid that would save and destroy the world.